Hello, I'm Isaac Edmondson, and I'm here with
Josh Bramel.
And we are at Fairview High School and on an imperfect weather day.
Oh, yeah, it's doing some little sleet slash snow here. Game just started between Fairview High School and Brentwood Academy.
Yes.
Both male teams. And starting off the game with Brentwood receiving the ball right there.
And they look like to be in control.
Nice
with
strong
wild
kick downfield in Fairview side.
And that's number 11.
And it is going to be, I believe, a corner kick. Or
Tony Arnold kicked that out of bounds for Fairview.
Throwing.
This game is fast-paced right now.
Oh, yeah, definitely in soccer. You can't just stand still. You have to be moving all the time.
Yes. And a booming kick downfield.
And
controlled by Brentwood Academy.
A nice save, keeping it in bounds by Brentwood.
And then, oh, he has a nice on-goal kick and good save by defender for Fairview.
Brentwood recovers the ball. A nice strong kick down, but it goes out of bounds. And goal is receiving. Tony Arnold getting ready to do the goal kick.
The goalie for Fairview is Benji Gonzalez right now.
A freshman.
Yes.
And so far he's doing a good job just keeping the pressure up on Brentwood's offense. So Brentwood recovering the goal kick right here.
They've had control of the ball most of this game so far. This is not
nice.
Good for Fairview.
Yeah.
They keep having
Fairview
open shots.
Heat it up a little bit. They're playing mostly in Fairview's defense right now. Fairview's defense, Jason Arnold kicking it back to
4-4.
To Jesse Wright.
And now we're down the field. And I can't see. It looks like the goal kick.
No, it's a throw in for Fairview.
Yeah.
Throwing for Fairview.
And it's like a penalty.
It's out of bounds. Or
he
penalty.
Did. He stepped over the line, apparently.
Penalty, all right. Throw in for Brentwood. Okay. Nice down to number 14 for Brentwood. And Fairview recovers the ball. Playing it right into Brentwood's defense right now, Brentwood Academy. And Brentwood Academy kicks it right into one of the defenders, and the defender is pushing up with the ball right now, keeping nice and control. Fairview gets the ball, and the ref calls penalty.
Or it's a timeout, injury timeout, I think.
Penalty, definitely.
And look at Courtney with her 4-4 speed right there, running down the court.
Running down the track, the court, just to make sure the player's all right.
And it looks like he is, but Courtney's still running after him.
All right, I believe that is Sean Anderson.
Thank you.
With the injury.
Yeah.
And the game picks up again.
Courtney is the athletic trainer here at Fairview High School.
Nice, strong goal kick from Benji.
By the way, just let him know.
But it was right back in Fairview's defense. Fairview's defenders could get right back upfield. And, a little push right there.
Yes,
ref called
it.
Nice. Nice call, ref.
And Fairview takes control now with the kick.
Yeah, here we go. PK right here.
But
And Tony Arnold with the penalty kick.
I would hate to be playing in this weather right now.
Yeah, it's cold. Your muscles got to be freezing right now.
Yep. And
all right, well, nice save from Fairview, number 4, Jesse Wright.
At least it's not completely wet right now. Because it just started this.
Yeah, definitely going to be a little slipping and sliding. Oh, a push, but ref didn't call. Ooh, a trip.
Oh, looked like he flopped there.
Ooh, small guy going up against Jesse Wright right there.
Not a good matchup.
But good recovery, good recovery. He's right back up. All right, it's going to be PK number 10 for a Gus Wilson from Brentwood Academy. Taking the PK.
Ryan, I don't know.
Nice, strong PK right down the Fairview's goal box.
Forrest Wright is still shaking up for Brentwood Academy right there.
Ooh.
Whoa, that looks like to be a push. Number 8 is still pushing up.
Ooh. Jake Sanders keeping that ball nice and tight.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So we're playing it on the midfield right now, right in the line. Ref called penalty.
Fairview takes control.
Once again, here we go. A nice solid kick downfield. Playing it back to defense, Tony Arnold with a nice booming kick to the right side of the field. Header by Jesse Wright. And here we go. At number 37, Jason Arnold getting the ball back to Jake Sanders. Jake Sanders playing desperately, got the pass back to Jesse Wright. And here, a nice kick downfield, but Brentwood intercepts the kick, bringing it right back up down to midfield to number 14. Number 9 for Brentwood kicking it to number 7. Number 7, a nice strong kick down to number 2. But he passes it, runs back once more. Another Brentwood kick, or return. Benji Gonzalez with the save right there. And here comes a nice booming kick right back down to midfield, but was intercepted by the Brentwood Academy player. And out of bounds for Brentwood Academy, another goal kick for Fairview.
Fairview needs to keep it on the other side here a little bit so they can start attacking the goal.
Yeah, it feels
Brentwood Academy has done a great job so far.
Academy's offense is definitely keeping the pressure up on Fairview right now.
Yes.
If the Fairview keeps playing like this, it's going to be a tough game.
Yeah.
All right, nice kick there for Brentwood Academy.
Nice recovery for Fairview, though. And number 27. It looks to be throw in for Fairview.
All right, the weather's clearing up right here. No more sleet / snow. It's all good now.
Yep.
Except for the
coldness factor, yeah.
Yeah, the cold and the clouds. All right, but back to Tony Arnold right there. Tony Arnold getting it right out of Fairview's defense, but it was intercepted once more by Brentwood Academy. Number 14, keeping up the speed to get that ball.
An out-of-bounds kick for Fairview.
Out-of-bounds for Fairview. Number 6 for Brentwood Academy. 26 for Brentwood Academy getting the ball back in.
Yeah, Cameron Dodd.
But it's another throw-in.
Cameron Dodd throws it back in to
Force Wright.
And out-of-bounds again.
Fairview's definitely trying to keep him out right here. Third throw-in within, 15 seconds right now. This is pretty intense right now.
Yeah, back to Mr.
Forrest Wright.
Right here.
Nice strong kick.
And he just slips. That's where the weather factor.
Yeah, the wet grass right there just kind of made him fall.
And
it's gonna
now
be
it's a goal kick for
goal
Fairview.
Kick for Fairview. Tony Arnold once more with it. Up, calling for subs.
Number 3 for Fairview.
Number 3 for Fairview is Sean Anderson, I believe.
And he is a senior.
Yes, he is. Playing forward mid right here for Fairview.
This is good to get some.
Ooh, nice head by number 17 for Fairview right there.
I think his name's Justin Damo,
Tony Arnold with the keeping it inside right there. So, Brentwood Academy right there, keeping up the pressure on Fairview's defense on the left side of the field right now. And out of bounds for Fairview. Fairview's throwing. And nice solid throw in.
They're pushing it upfield. Never mind.
Yep. Tony Arnold, being the good defender that he is, pushes it right back out. But it's no good because Brentwood Academy's offense is just too good right now. Ooh, little tripping and falling right there. That could have been a goal right there. But it's going to be another goal kick for Fairview.
That was a great pass to Forrest Wright. He almost had that.
Almost had that indeed. What a great play that would have been.
Yeah, that.
All right, Tony Arnold once more with a goal kick. Everybody setting up their positions right now. Jason Arnold's open.
And another booming kick down the field.
Indeed.
And
ooh,
nice
header
by
Brentwood Academy trying to go for the doubleheader, but he misses, and there's a little confusion right there.
But they're going back downfield.
Tony Arnold with the clear. Sean Anderson and Christian Suffrage trying to keep the ball on the Brentwood's side, but it didn't work out this time. Brentwood's ball. They keep passing it back. It's a nice stretch.
Good Benji save
Gonzalez
by Benji.
With the save. That was a nice shot. Attempt
yes,
right there
it
for
was.
Goal. And the Benji's thing. Nice, powerful boom right there.
They need to clear it out.
Yes, they do.
Benji's
and
taking up a lot of
a
shots.
Pass to Forrest Wright. Forrest Wright is keeping on that ball.
Yes, he's.
So far, there hasn't been a time in Brentwood's offense right now, Brentwood Academy's offense, that, there was a trip right there. On number 2, Fairview.
Christian Shelby, he went down hard right there.
But he's back up. Back up, and it's going to be a PK, and penalty kick. Tony Arnold's going to be taking the kick again. All right, everybody's setting up their positions again. Shelby is.
This is the first time in a while Fairview's gotten it that far down the field.
Yes, it has.
And they're controlling it right now. So,
and nice save from Fairview. Jake Sanders using his foot skills to keep the ball in Brentwood Academy's defense right now, giving the pressure on. There's all the Fairview's offense.
Oh, that was a nice shot attempt.
But Brentwood Academy's goalie with the save. That was a nice save. He dove for the ball, caught it. Brentwood Academy's nice boom downfield. Intercepted by Jesse Wright. Then Christian Suffrage taking the ball, keeping it right back down in Brentwood Academy's defense. Christian Shelby with the ball now, trying to use his footwork to keep the ball in his possession, but didn't work. He got double teamed right there.
Brentwood saves it right there.
Brentwood Academy with the ball. Keeping it. Ooh, they're playing close to the corners right there, and it's out of bounds. I believe it's Brentwood's ball. Brentwood's throwing.
And the sleet and slash snow is starting to pick back up again.
Yes, it is. It's light right now, but hopefully it'll clear up again. We just passed 30 minutes for the rest of the first quarter, or for the first half. So far, it's been a good game. No goals
very
yet.
Very
intense, very pressurized. There's a bunch of action happening right now.
Mm-hmm. I'm just glad they're keeping on Fairview side right now.
Yeah. Fairview has stepped up their game right here.
Most of the game has been all Brentwood Academy control. Now Fairview's taking control.
Yes, they are. Keeping it nice in the midfield to Brentwood Academy's defense.
That's a great play by number 7 for Baylor McKay.
For Brentwood Academy.
He's our captain.
Well, he takes a shot. Ooh, but Benji saved the ball. Knocked it out, but caught it back for the rebound. Benji's nice kick downfield.
His game for a freshman is pretty good.
Benji is a great goalie for a freshman right now.
Yeah.
If he keeps pursuing his career, his sport of soccer, he's going to be great when he comes to senior.
Mm-hmm.
Nice strong kick from Brentwood's defense right down to Fairview. Number 12 for Fairview, Will King. And Sean Anderson with the save right there, keeping the inbounds. Then it's Jake back to Jake Sanders, which passed it back to Jesse Wright. Jesse Wright pushing up on the right side of the field. A little slip by Christian Shelby, a little slip and fall right there for Fairview and Brentwood Academy. Brentwood Academy passing it back to the goalie. Goalie's going to kick it up. And nice strong kick downfield again, but intercepted by Christian Shelby. Christian Shelby with a nice slide kick to the ball, getting the ball out of bounds. And a throw in for Brentwood Academy.
The crowd is crazy right now.
Yes, they are. On the edge of their seats, hoping for Fairview to score that goal.
Yes, they are there. And they look to be bundled up over there. They're
a little definitely
cold.
Cold weather right now. You got to keep keep the heat, man.
Mm-hmm.
Brentwood's throwing. Brentwood with the ball right now.
They kicked it back downfield.
Tried to keep it out of defense, but Fairview getting the ball right here.
Keeping control.
Nice strong kick by Jake Sanders, but it wasn't good enough. Sean Anderson getting the ball.
Brentwood Academy seems to be going all the way. And again, their captain steps up, Baylor McKay.
Right here.
This great play by Tony, yes.
Tony Arnold playing that defense right now. Brentwood Academy takes the shot. Jesse Wright saves it with his head right there.
Oh, that was a nice play.
Ooh,
oh, good job.
Nice save by Benji. Dives to the ball.
That was close.
You can tell Benji's a good goalie just because of the dirt.
Yeah, he's
definitely
covered in mine.
Definitely tell that he's not afraid to dive for that ball.
Uh-uh.
It's a great quality. All goalies should have that. All
right. And midfield right now.
Number 5 for Brentwood Academy, keeping it nice for the Brentwood's offense. Passes it to number 26 back to 5. But number 10 for Fairview gets the ball. Christian Suffrage playing with the defense for Brentwood Academy right now. Gets it all the way downfield to number 37, Jason Arnold. And it is out of bounds. Brentwood Academy's corner kick throw-in. There's the throw-in for Brentwood Academy. Little slip up right there, but Brentwood Academy is recovering fast, passing it right back down to midfield.
Fairview stays in control, though.
Yes, they do. Number 12, keeping the ball in their possession. Number 11, Tony Arnold, passes it to number 12. Number 12 misses it. Brentwood Academy's defense pushing up.
McKay for number 7 from Brentwood Academy is
going to go up against Fairview's defense right here.
Nice steal.
There's a little push and fall right there. But the game is continuing. Nice pass to number 9.
Oh, Tony
takes
it out.
Nice save by Tony Arnold.
This is not looking for good numbers.
No, it's not.
Fairview right here.
Fairview High is once again letting Brentwood Academy right up into their side of the field.
Mm-hmm. But that was a nice play by the forward, Jake Saunders, to come all the way across the field and make a defensive play,
yes,
and he's on offense.
Oh, here we go right now.
That dude came out of nowhere. I did not even see him.
It was a nice strong break right there, but it just wasn't good enough for Fairview. Fairview's handling of the ball was turned over to Brentwood Academy right there, out of bounds. And the throw-in
a sub for Fairview comes into the game. I believe it's Sergio Chavez.
Number 14, Sergio Chavez.
Yeah.
And Sergio Chavez is playing the position of midfield right now, which means he's going to be constantly running up and down this field, trying to keep the ball in Fairview's handle, in the Fairview's possession. And it's a corner kick for Fairview. Jason Arnold, I believe, taking the kick. Everybody's setting up for anticipation of the kick. Brentwood's defense is ready for this, getting in formation like a wall to make sure that ball does not pass them and get in their goal.
And the score is still nil to nil.
Ooh, this is close. This is close for Fairview right here. But
is it the Fairview Stapes? Nope. It's Brentwood Academy ball, and now they're goalkeeping it.
Yes, they are. It's a goal kick.
I think this is their first goal kick so far.
I think this is their first goal kick as well. Fairview.
That's a good thing for Fairview now, though. They're picking it up.
Yeah, they are picking it up, trying to keep the pressure on Brentwood Academy's defense right here.
And this is interesting because they're keeping their goalie as a goal kick.
Yes,
Fairview has Tony goal kicking for them. So.
All right, here we go. Number 12 for Fairview, kicking the ball down to number 5, Jake Sanders, passing it back to number 12. But Brentwood Academy got a hit on the ball. Tony Arnold, ooh, there was a kick right there after contact with the ball. But ref didn't call it.
Well, booming kick downfield. Justin
Dombauer. Nice save right there, but he fell. And then Brentwood Academy back up with the pickup, bringing it right on downfield.
And the score is still 0-0.
Fairview's ball throw-in. With just 2 minutes above, or 2 minutes from 20 minutes away. And Tony Arnold with the recovery right here. Nice strong kick downfield. Brentwood Academy's offense or defense, number 8, heads it up and passes it on downfield. Christian Suffrage with the recovery. Nice strong kick down to Sean Anderson. Anderson, number 10 for Brentwood. Keep fighting out for the ball right there. Fairview recovered it. And playing it on midfield right now. Nice breakaway from Brentwood, keeping it strong. But Fairview's defense is just keeping on that ball right now, Isaac.
Yeah, they are. Justin made a great save right there. And that's a nice kick, but not close enough to make it a shot on goal. And Benji, who has been playing a really good game, does it to Tony. Tony's going to kick it.
Yes, it is. Brentwood just called for subs. Number 24 for Brentwood. Sam's still playing forward now.
And he's a senior, so he's going to bring in some leadership.
Yes, he will. All right.
And he looks eager. They look eager to score right here.
Oh, who wouldn't be? A nice strong kick from Fairview right on down to the goalkeeper of Brentwood Academy. Nice save from Brentwood Academy. Nice booming kick downfield. Jake Sanders close to recovering. Number 24 heading the ball out back to Brentwood Academy's defense.
They're trying to set up something right here,
yes,
but they couldn't.
And out of bounds. Fairview's ball throwing. Jesse Wright going to take that throwing.
Yeah, that almost hit us right there.
Yes, he did. That was a close call.
I think we should have saved it for him, but.
It's not our place right now.
Yes.
It's not our place. But here we go, throwing for Fairview. Jesse Wright passing it right on down to Sergio Chavez.
And it looks like it's about to be right out.
Ooh,
yep. And Jake
Saunders
keeps it out.
Keeping with the save, keeping it out of bounds, making sure Brentwood does not keep control of it. But in doing that, he did give Brentwood the ball. The throw-in right here. And Brentwood's throwing nice and strong over the heads. But Jake Saunders keeping
it in
possession. That was a
nice pass. Number
24, number 9, passing the ball. But little slip up there. And number 37, Jason Arnold, picking up the ball for Fairview.
Oh, dang.
Oop.
Nice call right there.
Nice call indeed.
It's still 0-0 with 20 minutes left to play. It's half of the first half.
Half of the first half right here.
Yeah.
With 20 minutes in the game, there's been 0-0, like Isaac just said. This is intense. These players are probably just dying for that little rest.
That was a nice pass, but it can't keep it.
Tony Arnold trying to keep that, but he missed.
Brentwood was really eager to score right there, too.
Since Brentwood is pushing up so much, their offense and defense, it looks like they're getting a little tired right now, Isaac.
Mm-hmm. They are.
Definitely a lot of wearing out right now.
And it seems Fairview has the bigger bench here, so.
Yeah, home field advantage, but number 14, Forrest Wright right here with a nice pass. But
Justin makes a nice header.
Yes, he does. Trying to keep the ball in Fairview's possession, but pass right on
and
over
Justin
his head after
it. Takes control. And it looks to be Luke Blankenship is hurt right here for Brentwood Academy.
Will King showing good sportsmanship, trying to help up number 15 right now.
Yeah, this game has had a few injuries,
quite more,
probably because of the rain and snow and sleet.
Yes, definitely.
And it's just getting a little muddy out here.
Yeah, the field's going to be muddy, slippery. It's going to be a fun game for soccer.
Yep, and it's going to hurt even more because, you know, they're already cold, so.
Oh, yeah.
And everything hurts more when you're cold.
It's just horrible, man. All right. So they're keeping it back in Fairview's defense again, just the way it started off in the first half.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
In the first half.
Yeah. Yeah, Fairview's just, it looks like they're not playing as much intensity right here.
Yeah, it looks like they're just trying to leisurely play on right now.
Yeah, they're just trying not to let them score, and that's it. They're not trying to score.
Yeah, they're just trying to conserve energy right now and make a good comeback later on, hopefully.
Yeah. And it's a goal kick for Brentwood Academy right here. Isaac
kick.
Way is going to kick it.
Field kick, actually. It's a corner kick.
Yeah, corner Isaac kick. Way with the corner kick.
Fairview setting up for the defense from the corner kick right now.
And it looks like they're going to get it. They're going to try to give it to either Baylor McKay or Forrest Wright.
Forrest Wright setting up far back. Just waiting to see if this kick can get right over their heads of Fairview.
Oh, and that was an awful corner kick right there for Brentwood Academy. It could have been played much better than that.
Yeah, but the rain definitely had a little bit of effect to that.
Yes, it did.
Making the ball a little slippery. Reducing the contact on the ball, but Brentwood recovers with the throw-in.
And it looks like they kicked it out of bounds right there. And
yes,
I think Fairview's going to throw it in.
Fairview is indeed going to throw it in, or going to take another goal kick. But I didn't see exactly where it went out. It looks like a throw-in from Will King. Right back down to Tony Arnold.
And Tony Arnold will boom it down the field, as he has been all game. And now Jay Saunders with Session kicks it up. Oh, and almost kicked it to Sergio Chavez. He got it right back. That was a nice kick. Oh.
Yeah. A nice kick from Sergio Chavez down to goal, but goalie for Brentwood Academy keeps it up.
Nice headbutt right there.
Yeah, Brentwood Academy's offense right now passing it on down.
Oh, that was a nice pass. Oh, he tried to save it, but he couldn't.
Tried to save it. And nice try by Forrest Wright right there.
Yeah, Forrest Wright looks to be a little shaky right there, getting up.
And it looks like it's Fairview's throwing right here. From Jesse Wright. Ref calls for subs.
Yeah.
And continues with the game, right on down to Sergio Chavez.
He missed it, but he got pushed right there a little bit, but no call.
Forrest Wright trying to make a recovery. And out of bounds once more. It is the Brentwood Academy's throwing right here. Number 26, Cameron Dodd.
That was almost bad because that would have went over the fence.
That was almost an out of bounds, and definitely.
That would have taken a few minutes off the clock trying to get the ball back.
Yeah. Pretty sure they have some spare balls, though, just in case that happens.
Yeah. I think they might need one soon because I bet this ball is soaking wet.
Probably. Nice throw in from Brentwood Academy down to number 7. Right back
right.
On down to Forrest Wright, but it's out of
bounds. He keeps kicking it out of bounds here.
Yeah, but
he's getting really frustrated.
Right on down to Jake Sanders.
Oh, Serge.
Passes on to Sergio Chavez.
Oh, and that's out of bounds.
Out of bounds.
Fairview.
Out of bounds for Brentwood Academy.
But now it's Brentwood.
All right, little confusion right there, but Brentwood Academy, Cameron Dodd with the throw in number 26. Right on down to number 24, but Justin's recovery out of bounds, but It is Brentwood Academy throwing number 26, Cameron Dodd, once more with a throw-in.
Oh, and he got pushed down. Oh,
a little bit of slip-up by between the team right there of Brentwood Academy. Christian Shelby right there.
There you go. Kicking it out. That was nice. Now Fairview goes with the attempt, and he looks like
Sean Anderson. Go, go.
Oh, he just kicked it over the goal.
That
he
was
wants
a nice shot attempt right there, but a little too much power went right over the goal, and his shoe flew off as well.
Yep, that was – he was looking for the call, too. He thought he got pushed, but
– no, he's mad.
Yes, he
he's
is.
He's mad.
I think it's just that he thought he should have made that, but
but he was moving down pretty fast. Yeah. It was definitely a hard shot to make.
Yep, and it was a just change in events because Brentwood Academy almost scored within at least 15 seconds of that.
Yes, they did. It was a close call right there from and from Fairview's defense, kicking it out.
But then they made a great play to come back on offense.
Yes, they did. Goalkeeper kick doing the goal kick right here for Brentwood Academy. Right on down to the right side of the field. Number 14, Forrest Wright, kicking it down to Tony Arnold in Fairview.
And he
Tony
kicks
Arnold
it back to Sergio.
It back to Benji.
Oh, Benji, my bad.
Benji did a nice kick downfield, but it was intercepted by Brentwood Academy number 9. But number 9 tries to make the goal. It was a miss. There's been three shot attempts for Brentwood Academy right now.
Yeah, that was close, so that scared me. I thought
that was going to go in.
Yeah, me too. I thought he came up short because it looked like he's on the dive. But luckily, he got a hand on it.
Oh, corner
Brentwood
kick.
Academy.
Corner kick right there.
Corner kick. Oop. Oh, nice save by.
Close call for Fairview right there. The ball almost went in right there.
Yep, it was a nice save by Christian Shelby right there.
Christian Shelby making sure that ball does not get in that goal right there. Kicking it downfield for Sean Anderson and getting the ball out of the goalie box.
Isaac Way is going to kick it here, the corner kick. And again, they're probably going to try to give it to Forrest Wright, number 14.
Number 2 is right in the middle right there. Number 26
and
yeah, tries
Forrest
the
Wright
header.
Got
Forrest
it.
Wright gets the ball. But Sean Anderson gets it, but it goes out of bounds. And it is Brentwood Academy's ball. Cameron Dodd once more with the throw-in. Cameron Dodd is a sophomore.
So as Forrest Wright, Brentwood Academy has a young team.
Indeed they do. Looking at the roster right now, they actually have an 8th grader.
Yep, they do.
An 8th grader, Ben Mason. Cameron Dodd once more with the throw-in. Look at that. Right on down to 24.
Oh, but and he
good.
Kicks
and
that.
Justin gets
almost onto
out
the
of
tennis courts.
Over the fence. At least that it did not go inside the goal right now for Fairview.
Yeah. That was a smart play to kick it out.
Yes, it was.
Now they have a new ball, maybe not as wet, so them have more traction on kicking it. And that was a nice play.
Goal.
Oh, and goal for,
Brentwood
Academy.
It's 1-0 right now. That
with 11:40 left in the game. That was a great play.
An intense game right now. First goal of the game for Brentwood Academy.
And it looked to be Makia Azad with the goal right there, a sophomore. Yeah. Right. He's a midfield.
Fairview setting up for the kick right now, the kickoff. Passing it back to Jake Sanders. Jake Sanders passing it back to Jesse Wright. Jesse Wright to Tony Arnold. Tony Arnold down to Sergio Chavez,
and
but it goes out of bounds.
On Brentwood Academy,
yep.
I think number
Fairview's
11
ball.
Headed it.
Fairview's ball right here. Fairview's throwing. Here we go. Right on down to Sean Anderson, but goes over the head. Passes it. Brentwood Academy gets the ball, passes it back on downfield, but it's out of bounds. Jesse Wright with the throw-in. Trying to get it down to Jason Arnold, but it did not work. Got intercepted by the Brentwood Academy's defense. Number 9, Brentwood Academy. Seth Coomer, a senior,
and
making sure the ball is getting out of his side of the field.
Yeah, this is more of a day to drink hot chocolate than to play soccer. And it looks like they're calling offsides, so it's Fairview's ball here.
Yeah, Fairview's ball indeed. Tony Arnold going to be doing kicking off right here. Everybody setting up for the for the recovery of the ball. Tony Arnold, nice strong kick downfield, but there's nobody who was there to recover it. I think he overshot it a little bit trying to get it down to Sean Anderson, but Brentwood Academy recovered it. And Will King trying to keep it off his side.
Oh, that was a nice play by Shelby right there, and he kicks it right to Brentwood Academy, though, so they get to take control.
It's downfield, though.
Now it's Fairview's ball for the head-in, or the throw-in, with 9:31 left in the game, and Brentwood Academy is up 1-0.
Yes, only a little bit under 10 minutes left in the first half of the game right here. It's been an intense game, took 30 minutes to get the first goal. Hopefully, both teams are going to get a nice, well rest in the halftime, making sure they can keep up the pressure they're having right now. Both teams doing a great job at keeping pressure on offense and defense for both sides.
This crowd hasn't seemed to be much of a factor yet. They're
not as
loud as a home crowd should be, but maybe they'll pick it up too in the second half.
If Fairview gets momentum, the crowd should definitely be cheering.
Yes, but I think the weather does have a factor in that.
Yeah, definitely.
They're a little
too
cold to be cheering.
It's cold. Nobody wants to be here.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding. Everybody wants to come out and just to watch soccer tonight.
Yeah. They are having some Fairview pride, major Fairview pride to still
right
be here.
Showing that jacket pride.
And the baseball game across the road is being played right now. And Fairview is losing 4-5 to Waverly in the fifth inning. Just to give y'all a baseball update while we're out here.
And it is a kickoff for Brentwood Academy right here. Number 10, I'm sorry, with a nice strong kick.
Oh, a nice header, but nice save by Benji.
But Benji got the ball. That was a nice save by Benji Gonzalez.
That was a great header, too, for Brentwood Academy's Baylor McKay right there.
Definitely, their captain is definitely picking it up.
Yeah. You can tell why they're winning right now. He's definitely been a main factor in this game for them.
Yes, he is. Forrest Wright is a junior. No, he's actually a sophomore.
Yeah, Forrest Wright he's been another key factor for Brentwood Academy.
Right,
and he almost got the ball right there. But then their captain, pushes it down the field. And Justin
Dumbarger
makes a great play right there.
Oop. Ref called it.
And it looks like they called a push on Justin Dombo right there. And Jake Sanders is trying to tell him to calm down. And
Jesse Sanders making the call for the wall right here.
And Gus Wilson is another captain for Brentwood Academy. He's kicking it right here. And
the wall. But there was a nice curve by number 10 for Brentwood Academy, getting around the wall.
And Jake Sanders kicks it out and almost took out
the equipment right there.
Yes.
That was a close save. Close call right there, not a save. I'm sorry.
And our camera crew, Holly Connor, is doing a great job
making sure that the ball is covered
and
out of bounds.
She's still somehow filming the game. And
yep. We're shorthanded right now, so Holly has to try to pick up all the slack as she can. Make sure you guys get a nice video.
I bet the soccer team can't wait for the spring weather to come back.
Throwing.
I have not understood this weather, though, lately. It'll feel good, like 70 to 80 degrees one day, and then the next day you come out and it's like this at 34.
It's just that time of the year, man.
It's snowing, yep.
Just can't wait for summer. Be more primetime football, soccer. Ooh, there was a little trip and fumble right there for Fairview.
Yeah, number 10, Gus Wilson, the captain for Brentwood Academy, threw down Fairview. And Fairview,
Christian Suffrage.
He looks a little mad right there.
Yes, he does. There's a little rumble tumble right there.
Yeah. He's a senior, so hopefully he'll keep calm so he doesn't.
He's got to keep that senior composure.
Yeah, he has to make sure, because the team definitely looks up to their senior. So
yes, they do.
If he starts fighting back, then that'll lead the whole team to.
All right, Tony Arnold with the PK right here. Brentwood tries to make a wall, but Tony gets it a little over their head.
But
Brentwood with the recovery, passing it down. But number 12, Will King gets the ball, passing it down to number five, which passes it down, tried to get it to Tony Arnold, but it was a little overshot. Jesse Wright getting down to Jason Arnold.
Oh, and a good kick. Oh, and
tried to get it back. There was a close call there, mm-hmm. but Brentwood Academy's defense right there, they just kept it in their possession. Throwing for Fairview, back down to Will King. Will King keeping pressure on the ball.
4 minutes and 34 seconds left in this half.
The players are definitely tired. They need their rest. Their muscles are tired. They're worn out.
And dirty. Very dirty.
Yeah, definitely dirty.
Fairview looks a lot dirtier just because they have white uniforms.
Yeah, the white uniforms definitely show them more dirt.
And, yeah, you can tell they're fatigued right now. They need some water. They're just trying to stick it out for the rest of the half.
But the goalkeepers for both teams, they've been the same goalkeeper for this half.
Yeah, and they've done a great job.
Yes, they have.
Brentwood Academy has had no goal scored on them until
that was a close one.
I almost
right there.
Jinxed them. I wish I did. And Fairview they've only had one goal, but Benji, he's probably saved over 20 shots he's been a factor in 20 shots at least so far.
Yes, he has. Benji Gonzalez, the freshman, mm-hmm. has only missed one of the shots right now.
But there's have been a lot of shot attempts.
Yes, there have. There's been at least 5 to 7 shot attempts made on Fairview's goal. Mm-hmm. Goal kick from Brentwood Academy. Nice contact down to try to get it back to their defense and offense. But
Jake Sanders
with the cover right there.
And 24.
Jesse Wright. Ooh, playing it tough and rough with the defense right there. For Brentwood Academy. Out of bounds. Ref calls for subs with 2 minutes and 50 seconds left on the clock. This is an intense game, and the players are just waiting for that buzzer to ring.
Mm-hmm. I think they want a heater out here right now, the way it's feeling.
Oh, yeah. Definitely be better if it was an indoor field, but it wouldn't have that soccer feel. Soccer feel.
Yeah. I understand what you meant. It is confusing.
All right.
And Justin kicks it over the fence
again.
That's the second ball.
Second time.
The one almost hit us.
Yeah, but the reasonable play is by Justin keeping the ball out of the side of the field. But recovery and a throw-in from Brentwood Academy.
Tony booms it downfield, and it looks.
Brentwood Academy keeping the pressure on the ball from Fairview. Jason Arnold passing it down to Sean Anderson, but the pass wasn't as strong because it was intercepted by Brentwood Academy.
Oh, that was a good kick.
Brentwood Academy with the header, keeping it in their possession.
Oh, ooh, and he...
A little push and falling down right there for Fairview and Brentwood. Jason Arnold and McKay.
It looked like, Jason Arnold pushed him. He came from behind. He's a freshman.
Yeah, he is. These freshmen are just like on the girls' team. They play to their heart's content, man.
Yep.
Jason Arnold with the ball, but...
It got stolen away.
Messed up right there between the teams.
And Brentwood Academy takes control. That
was close.
Way too
right
close.
There.
Almost gave me another heart attack right here.
Ooh, 2 minutes left in the clock. Tony Arnold once more with the goal kick. And he's going to try to get it down to Christian Shelby. And right on down middle.
For some reason, the clock hasn't been playing. And
yeah, the clock is not going down.
10 seconds. It does stop at 2 minutes, I think. Yeah.
Oh!
Goal!
For Fairview. That is 1-1 for Fairview Brentwood Academy. This is intense game. Fairview picked it up. Sean Anderson with the goal. And Brentwood Academy is ready to take the kickoff. This is definitely going to boost Fairview's morale right here.
Yeah, that made...
The crowd was a little more active right there just because of the intensity right there.
Yes. That makes Fairview is going to go out in the second half with much more intensity because they're, hype right now because they got a goal. And it's 1-1. here with less than 2 minutes to play.
Yeah, this is definitely intense. The buzzer should be ringing any time soon.
Yeah.
The players are definitely going to be relieved when they hear that sound.
Mm-hmm.
Number five and number seven, Fairview and
Fairview's just trying to keep their tempo up right here.
So they are passing it from Tony Arnold down to Benji Gonzalez. There was contact, but the ball didn't seem to go as far as Benji wanted it to.
Yeah.
But Brentwood back with the recovery.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, no. Number 11. 11. And there's the time. First half of the game is over. Brentwood Academy, Fairview High School, 1-1.
1-1, yeah.
1-1.
It's been a very intense, full of action first half here, and Fairview seems to have the momentum going into the second half because they just scored the goal under 2 minutes left. So they're going to come out with a lot of energy and tempo in the second half.
Yes, they are. But I'm a little worried, though, just because of the time, the halftime from the morale boost from that one goal, it might go down just a little
bit.
Yeah,
that's the only thing I'm afraid of. But hopefully they'll keep it with them right here.
And
they're just glad they get a break. So we'll start up the second half here in a couple of minutes.
And
we'll be back shortly.
Yes, we will.
And number 10 seems to kick the cross field.
We're back for the second half of the game. Josh Bramble, Isaac Edmondson.
Yes. This game is intense right now. It's tied up.
1-1.
Last half.
We ended up with Fairview scoring one goal on the very end of the first half.
Mm-hmm.
And they've been playing aggressive so far. It's been in and out of Brentwood Academy's defense right here.
Yes, it has.
For this first half of the game, or last half of the game, beginning of it.
And Fairview has been playing hard. And Fairview, Brentwood Academy seems to be throwing it in right here. Brentwood Academy throws it in. And again, they start out strong like they did last half with the ball on their side. And out of bounds. And out is Fairview's ball. Fairview, Tony Arnold is going to kick it downfield, and that was a nice kick. And it looks like it didn't really go that far, though, as Brentwood Academy still has the ball in Fairview's territory. Brentwood Academy keeps it there, and that captain is playing very aggressive right now. And ooh, it looked like he got pushed onto Tony Arnold, and they both get up okay. And Brentwood Academy throws it in. And it's still 1-1 right here. It's a little cold to be playing soccer, I still think. And Fairview takes control, and they are booming down.
Sean Anderson. Sean Anderson. Keep it on. But number 37, Jason Arnold right here. Freshman, keeping on that ball.
Yes, he is intense right now.
Little fall by Sean, but he's not letting it halt him. Gives back up. Justin with a nice save. And it's back down in Fairview's defense.
Yeah, I'm just glad nobody has been severely injured this game. There has been a lot of knockdowns, but nobody's been severely injured with a broken arm or leg or anything. So that's a good thing.
Yeah, it's definitely lucky considering the wetness of the field right now.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely a good thing right there.
Courtney, the athletic trainer here.
Fall right there.
She's been doing a lot of work today, running off on and off the field.
Injured player for Fairview, it seems. And
I can't really tell what number it is because so far.
Number 2, I believe, Christian. Christian Shelby.
Yep.
No, I think that actually might be a freshman.
Oh, he is hurt. He's limping off the field.
Is that Will King?
But Trey Summerfield, he is the pet man here at Fairview. He gets football and basketball hype during the games and the student sections. He checks in the game. And Brentwood Academy is in control right here. And their captain is leading their team right now in the field. And turns over Jake Sanders, kicks it to Trey Summerfield. Trey Summerfield kicks it to Christian Shelby.
Jason Arnold.
Yeah.
passing on and getting the ball. And it seems to be recovered by Brentwood Academy. Oh, there's a little pushing ball right there.
Oh, and Trey jumped on the ball. That was a never seen move right there.
Contact on that ball, man. Number 12 for Brentwood Academy getting the ball. Down number 2. Number 9 passing it, but it got taken up by Jason Arnold. Couldn't out of bounds. Could be Brentwood's throw in, I believe.
It is so cold out here, folks. I don't know how they're doing it right now.
This definitely shows how fit these players are for both teams, having to endure this cold right now. Moving a lot, so it's maintaining their heat, which is great. Ooh, a breakaway.
Yes.
Sean Anderson right here.
He is fast, folks.
Yes, he is, but there's a little switch up with his feet right there, and the ball got ahead of him. And it's going to be a throw-in for Fairview. And Jason Arnold with the header.
Jason Arnold is another freshman for Fairview High School. He's been making a lot of impact plays.
Yes, he has.
This team. And Trey, who just checked in, is already making an impact. And it looks like he got pushed.
A little bit. And Tony Arnold getting it down to Dominic Hazelwood. But the defense got right on top of it and pressured Dominic so much.
Tony Arnold, who has been the...
with the ball.
Nice header there for Brentwood Academy. Two headers back-to-back. That gave him control of the ball. That was nice team play right there for him.
Oh, player calling for ball, but Alex Dowdy called for ball, but Brentwood Academy got the ball again.
The fans are very involved this half. I can hear them screaming a lot more than I could in the first half.
I can hear that too. They're definitely seeing that they're getting more into the game, which is good. It's going to boost morale for both teams.
Mm-hmm. Especially the home team, since they'll have a little bit more fans, hopefully.
It's going to be a goal kick, I believe, for Fairview.
And yep. Tony Allen will take the honors again.
Tony Arnold getting the goal kick.
And it's still 1-1 Fairview High School
with 10
and Brentwood Academy.
With 30 minutes left in the second half of the game.
It might go into overtime here.
It might go into overtime indeed.
These teams are playing really good defense, and they're keep it up though. But maybe they'll score late in the half. That was a nice kick, a nice play, nice kick back. Ooh, oh, and a nice save
for Fairview.
Oh, that was close.
Number 5, Nick Coomer, a freshman for Brentwood Academy, trying to get that in the goal, but it just didn't work.
Brentwood Academy is staying down there. And
ref called for a penalty foul
on Brentwood Academy
right there.
I think they called a handball.
Maybe.
Because when he bounced it up off his foot, it looked like it hit his hand.
Tony Arnold taking the kick again. Tony Arnold is definitely Fairview's prized kicker, it seems.
Yes, he's been taking a toll on a lot of these kicks. And
number 7,
Brentwood Academy's captain is
the ball, takes a shot attempt, but Benji Gonzalez saves a little trip right there, but he's right back up, and I believe he's going to take a nice power kick. Good contact down to Jake Sanders, I believe. Yeah, Jake Sanders. But Brentwood Academy with the recovery. Another save from Benji Gonzalez. Nice dive for the ball. Benji Gonzalez is definitely not giving up for Fairview's save. Another strong kick down. But Brentwood Academy's tip-off right there got them the ball.
Ooh,
jumping flips right there.
Yeah, he took a hit right there. I don't know how he got up so fast on that one.
Ooh, player just locked legs on the ball.
Dominic Hazelwood with the kick. And Fairview needs to be attacking more. They're just kind of like holding their ground, making sure they don't get scored on. They're not attacking
That's what it seems to be. Beginning of this half, they started playing a little harder. But looks like they're falling back.
They're being more protective than they are aggressive right here. They need to be more aggressive. And our camera workers, Holly Connor, is doing a very good job in this game.
She's still picking up because of the shortage on cameramen we have today.
Mm-hmm. And just
Trey Summerfield with the throw from Fairview. But there's a little overshot. And number 9 for Brentwood Academy, passing on down to defense, number 26. And a nice strong kick from him downfield for Brentwood Academy. Ooh, a nice strong kick, but
And a goal. Oh, wait, timeout. This is confusing. That could have been a goal, but I heard the referee blow his whistle before he passed it to get that goal. So
it's definitely going to make some of the Brentwood players mad about that.
Oh, yes. Yeah, they are not counting that goal.
Saved this, by the referee's whistle for Fairview right there.
This coach is infuriated for Brentwood Academy right now. Him and his assistant coaches are screaming like crazy.
Yes, they are.
And this is going to take a toll on their players right here.
Ooh. Benji Gonzalez saw that one goal, but the ref didn't call it. And he's making sure that it is staying outside of his box now.
Yes, he is not wanting to give up another goal.
No, he's not. He is not ready for it.
If he's been out here this long in this weather, he's going to make sure his team wins.
Yes, he is. He's going to keep that ball out of his box. Everybody setting up for the corner kick here. Nice strong kick from Brentwood Academy. A little over, though. And ref calls something. Looks like it's going to be Fairview's ball. A kick from Justin, not Tony this time. Looks like Fairview's giving Tony a little break right here.
And nice kick out.
Will King in the game again. Keeping it out of Fairview's box. Brentwood Academy's goalie pushing up a little bit out of his box right there, because the way that Fairview's playing right now, it's not going to go out of our defense so far.
It's still 0-0 out here on this under 30 degree weather. At least the snow and sleet stopped.
Yes, that's definitely good.
And Fairview,
the players.
Fairview looks like they're taking charge. And he's getting pushed all the way down. I don't know why there wasn't a foul right there. But Jay Saunders is still doing it.
Jason Arnold with the ball. But passes it back down to Trey Summerfield. Trey Summerfield with the ball. But it goes out of bounds.
No, I don't know. Looks like
it's going to be a throw in and or corner kick for Brentwood Academy. Corner kick for Brentwood Academy. It seems because players are setting up in the defensive position right now. And I hear some screaming from Fairview saying, make a wall. The wall is definitely going to be helping out right here if they can get that set up. Looks like we only got two players setting up the wall right here. The rest of them are covering their men.
Because last time Brentwood Academy scored, it was a goal kick they scored off of. It was a delayed they scored off after. And it looks like they might get another corner
looks
kick right here.
Yet another goal kick for Brentwood Academy right here. Fairview is just keeping this ball out of bounds right now, trying to make sure that it does not get anywhere near the goalie box.
Nice save by the freshman, but it looks like
there was a little tumble and fall right there.
It looked like Brentwood Academy tried to kick it when the goalie had possession of it. That's definitely.
Will King's going to be taking the ball right here. Players are setting up. If Fairview keeps playing like this, given time for other teams to set up, it's definitely going to be another tough game for Fairview.
They keep giving possessions over and over again to them.
Yes, they do. Looks like it is Brentwood Academy's ball. It's going to be a kickoff from number 10, Gus Wilson, a senior. Everybody setting up again, giving time for both teams to get in their spots. This, with 23 minutes left in the second half.
Nice save. That save looked really cool, too, because he slid and caught it.
Ooh, a nice strong kick from Benji down to number.
Oh, I can't really see. He fell down.
Two, Christian Shelby. Yep. There was a little slipping right there for Brentwood Academy and Christian Shelby.
The players have been taking a lot of falls today.
Yes, they have.
They just keep getting up, though. That's
definitely trooping on.
Uh-huh.
And they're playing good soccer. That's what this is all about.
Mm-hmm. And nice sportsmanship, I see, most of the time.
Ooh, a little fall right there. Christian Shelby avoids his teammate by jumping over him. Ooh, there was a slide right there.
Another push. This game is getting out of control. Subs. Tony
Arnold's coming in for Trey Summerfield.
Trey put in some work right there. He did a good job.
Yes, he did.
He made a nice spurt of energy for the Jackets.
He's definitely, like you said earlier, he's the pep guy for Fairview High School.
Yeah, he's going to get them. He got them hype right there.
Ooh.
Oh, and a nice kick over the goal. I hate those kicks because you can't tell until after.
Especially from our position right now, that definitely could have gone in from what we saw.
They just make you almost feel like you're about to have a heart attack because you don't know. It's just the suspense, man.
Tony Arnold taking up his position. Getting ready to take the goal kick. There it is. A nice, strong kick down to midfield.
Yeah. I think he needed that break right there.
Yes, he did. He's been playing as hard as he can, 110%.
All game.
Yes, he has. That's a great quality of a soccer player right there. But it seems that even with his presence back on the field, Brentwood Academy still keeping pressure on the ball.
Yeah.
And it's back with Brentwood Academy right here. Throw in for Brentwood Academy number 12.
Fairview needs to try to push it up the field right here and stop playing back. They need to be more aggressive.
Nice Christian Suffrage from Tony Arnold, but Brentwood Academy's number 10 keeping it right out. And it seems that we have Fairview's possession again. Ooh, there was definitely a little trip right there. Fairview's ball, good call, ref. And Tony Arnold once more with the PK kick. With the PK. Number 10 and number 31 for Fairview. Try and keep this ball in their possession. Oh.
Oh, that I don't think he missed well, that whistle right there.
Ref called a penalty, I believe. Yes, number 10 for Brentwood Academy. Kid getting ready to take the kick again. A nice, strong kick, but it goes out of bounds, and it looks like it's going to be a goal kick for Fairview again. The fans are definitely dying down right now.
As long as the intensity of this game. Yeah, the intensity of this game has fallen down, too. They seem to have taken the flow to the players because the players are very intense. Now they're getting into it.
Yeah. I guess they're just tired of seeing the ball down in Fairview's side of the field.
Yep.
Happy to see it in Brentwood's side of the field for a change. It is still Fairview's ball. They're going to keep it nice and in their possession right now. The players are walking on the field trying to give themselves a little rest. With 20 minutes left in the first half, or the second half. This is the last half of the last half of the game right here, guys. This is going to be an intense 20 minutes left.
Yeah, this is when both teams scored their point.
Yes,
the last half under the 20-minute mark. And that breeze does not feel good right there.
Doesn't. Just imagine what the players are feeling right now in those shorts.
Yep. And some of them aren't even wearing long sleeves, which would be.
And these players definitely are trying to keep it in their possession. And it is out of bounds. And I believe it is, yep, Fairview throw and nice down to.
Oh, that one right in between. But Christian's
his header was a little overboard. And it passed right on through Christian Suffrage's legs. Ooh, nice slide kick right there.
Isaac kicks it down on the field for Brentwood Academy.
Yes, he does. Number 14 and number 12, Will King and Forrest Wright trying to keep this ball, fighting for that ball. Will King trying to keep it out of the box and Forrest Wright to get it in the goal. And it looks like Fairview gets the ball, but it gets kicked out of bounds. And it's going to be a throw-in for Brentwood Academy, I believe.
This wind is killer right now.
The wind is going to have definite impact on the way the players play and how the ball is going to react when it gets kicked.
Yes, it does. And
Brentwood's throwing right there, passing it right on down to Brentwood Academy's offense. Brentwood Academy's offense passing it back to their defense. Defense back to offense, number 12. And, ooh, they're forward right there, keeping it nice up into Fairview's offense. Passing it. These guys definitely are doing a lot of passing, trying to get that down. Ooh, that was close.
Shot attempt
from Brentwood Academy, but just missed the goal. That was a nice attempt. The wind probably carried it away just a little bit there.
So scary right there. And Fairview has two subs in. Blake number 27. He's a freshman, Blake Langford, and Sergio, number 12, Sergio Chave comes into the game. And Christian Subert takes it, passes it to Jake Sanders, and Jake Sanders, it's a nice kick.
Sean Anderson. Anderson got a little bit ahead of the ball right there.
And Christian Subert, oh, he gets the...
Ooh, there's a little contact there. But the wind curved the ball back on down. Forced right for Brentwood Academy, getting the ball downfield. And Justin getting the ball up, back up. Hits the ref. And ref calls ball for Brentwood Academy. Throw in. And it's gonna, it looks like it's going to be passed right on down to Forrest Wright. And it seems that it's another out of bounds, but it's Fairview's ball this time. Ref calls her sub. And nice
the band
throw.
Seem to be a little angry. The referees right now, as they're screaming at him.
Yeah, they are. And Fairview's ball is... The ball is still on Fairview's side of the field defense right now.
Oh, nice kick downfield and nice headbutt back.
Number 10 for Brentwood Academy, keeping it.
Sergio kicks it down to Christian Suffers. Suffers looks to beat his man, and he... Oh, it's a push. Number 10 pushes him.
Number 10 passes it on down to the goalie.
He can't.
Christian Suffers was trying to get on that ball.
He kicked it out of bounds. That's a smart play right there because Christian's hungry for a goal right here.
Christian is looking for a goal. Indeed.
Brentwood Academy just saves it from going out of bounds.
Ooh,
and it looks to be like a slide tackle.
Right there, knocking three players down. And it looks like Dominic Hazelwood taking in the throw. Actually, I'm sorry, that was Justin taking in the throw. And here we have Brentwood Academy getting the ball back again. Number 25. Return the ball down to number 5, back to number 12 from Brentwood Academy. Sergio Chavez trying to get the ball, but he just couldn't get it right there.
And it's out of bounds, and Brentwood Academy's ball. They throw it in. The game was much more intense. Now it's getting close to an end. Only 15 minutes left to play now, and it's still 1-1. Right here.
These players don't want to go into overtime. They just want to get out of this cold weather.
Yes,
they're
they do.
Trying as hard as they can.
I think some of the fans do too, and the coaches, and maybe the camera worker. She says she wanted to go home. We're just a little cold here. This is not soccer weather. Soccer weather needs to be closer to the spring.
Yes, it does. But this is still the main time for soccer for boys, and looks like it's gonna be a corner kick for Brentwood Academy down in Fairview side of the field.
I bet they can't even tell when they kick the ball. Their toes must be frozen.
Oh yeah, definitely gonna have some sore feet tomorrow morning.
Sore everything, because they have been falling a lot lately.
Oh, yes, they have.
It's been slippery.
Yes, they're gonna be insanely tired. Everybody on this field right now is exerting themselves to their full potential. Even though they're walking because they're tired, these guys definitely, a trip and fall slide. Two players are down, but they get right back up, showing true sportsmanship, trying to keep this game going.
This is a very intense game right now. It's so close. With just a little time left, and Fairview is making a wall right here because they do not want to lose this game after all this effort.
They do not want to be out playing in this cold just to lose.
Oh, shit.
They want this win.
This is...
Oh, it's going to be a PK, actually. Right in front of the goal. We have three players making up the wall. Jesse Wright, Sergio Chavez. Sergio Chavez tries to get... blocked by jumping, but the ball curved to his left.
And Brentwood Academy still remains in control.
Yes, they do.
Oh, and it's a nice kick. Oh, that was a
nice
save.
Nice save by Benji Gonzalez, making sure the ball does not go in to Benji Gonzalez. Little throw right there down to Sergio Chavez, passing it on down to Jesse Wright. But number 5 for Brentwood Academy, trying to keep it inside Fairview's defense.
Everybody's jumping around in the crowd and the coaches are, as it's getting a little colder, dropping the weather as the sun has went down. So
yes, definitely. Oh my goodness. It seems that these parents in the bleachers are standing up trying to get some heat again.
And they're trying to get loud for their team because
they're trying to boost morale right here.
Mm-hmm. Because I think
nice kick from Brentwood Academy, but
ooh. Oh, and he looked like whiff on that kick right there. Ooh. Ooh, that was a nice dodge by Fairview. He ducked out of the way so it could get in the goal kick.
Yep. And the goal kick is Tony Arnold once more. Getting ready to take the kick. Nice contact with the kick, sending it right on down to the right side of the field. But Brentwood Academy's defense was right there waiting for him.
Ooh, and it looks like he's going to beat him out. That
Christian Suffrage with the breakaway.
He is so
fast. Trying to take it all the way.
Oh,
nice shot attempt for Fairview High School, but the goalie kept up his game and got the save. Nice save from Brentwood Academy.
The goalie seems to try to be getting hype right here for
yes,
that
he
save.
He's been pushing up, trying to yell at his team, getting them hyped up as well. Definitely after a play like that, Brentwood Academy is definitely going to try to keep more pressure on that ball.
Mm-hmm.
And out of bounds, Fairview's throw in, I believe. And it looks like I am right throwing from Fairview.
The wind is definitely having an impact on the ball movement right now.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Another throw-in for Fairview. Jesse Wright taking all the throw-ins for Fairview. Trying to get it down to number 14, Sergio Chavez.
That was a nice kick downfield, a nice kick for Brentwood Academy.
Casting it up. But
Blake Langford
trying to keep on that ball.
He got pushed from behind.
It was a little trip and fall. Blake, it looks like he's down but hurting. And he's up. Tony Arnold's going to take this kick. This is going to decide a goal over here. Right?
Blake seems to be getting a little shaken up after that. But it seems like he's okay.
That was a nasty fall. But
Tony Allen or Arnold kicks it all just above the goal.
Oh, my bad.
Oh, shoot. We have to get out of the way. All right. Sorry, I was in the way right there. My bad.
And it is the goal kick for Brentwood Academy. Brentwood Academy, nice contact with the ball, sending it downfield. Recovery, number 12, passing it down. But the defender missed the ball, passing it downfield. It looks like it's out of bounds for Fairview, I believe. Going to be a throw-in for Fairview.
And under 10 minutes left to play in this game right here.
Yeah, under 10 minutes, 9 minutes and 20 seconds right now.
It's still 1-1, though.
Yeah,
so
still 1-1. This is definitely going to be an intense 9 minutes left in the game.
Yes, it is.
These players don't seem like they wanted to go in overtime. They wanted to get it over fast so they can go home, back to the warmth.
Get in a blanket and some hot chocolate in.
Oh, man, this weather is, it's not the worst, but it's definitely not the best.
Yes.
It's definitely not the best.
That was a great save again by Benji.
Benji Gonzalez. Nice, strong kick downfield.
And Shelby
getting the ball, passing it down to number 10, Christian Shelby. And he misses the ball right there. Almost gets the hand, but he moves it just in time. Nice, strong kick downfield. Goalie for Brentwood Academy. Nice save right there. Passing it down to number 9. Number 9 to number 12.
Oh, Shelby with the great play right there.
And looks like it is a throw-in for Brentwood Academy. And Brentwood Academy's ball. And
yep.
Looks like it's going to be a corner kick right now.
I bet this is the coldest game they have played in a while this year.
Yep. Definitely one of the colder games right now.
Mm-hmm. Maybe the coldest game they will play all year.
I hope so. This weather should not come back for these players.
Nope, it should just get warmer and fast. we want spring.
We all enjoy some warm weather. The rest of the season, they would love it.
Yes, everybody would, I think.
Yeah, definitely for wherever you're at, warm weather would definitely help you guys at home field advantage.
Yes. And if and the wind stopped blowing, then that's bounds. A good thing.
Oh, no, it's still inbounds. Oh, ref called.
No, goal kick for Fairview.
For Fairview High School, yep. Tony Arnold, once more with a goal kick. The man that needs no introduction anymore. Whenever you say goal kick, you know it's him.
Yep. Fairview pushing it up. Oh, gets blocked. And
out of bounds, hits one of the viewers, but doesn't matter to him. He passes the ball right back onto the team. Team throws it in. And it's playing right by his feet again.
And they're moving really fast right now because they know they're running out of time.
Yes, they are.
Brentwood Academy
definitely trying to keep up right now, trying to keep up the pace, making sure the ball stays in Fairview side of the field. Fairview still playing a little too defensively.
And it seems to be, I think, a goal kick here for Brentwood Academy. And goal kicks are always... are always dangerous.
Yes, they are.
We definitely don't want to see them score right here with 6 minutes left remaining in this game.
On the clock. Definitely a cold game. The players are definitely ready for this game to end.
Aren't we all? But I bet it is very intense watching at home. Oh, nice save, Bob.
But the player keeps the ball out of the goal box. Benji Gonzalez trying to get the ball for the recovery, passing it on down to the man that needs no introduction, back for the goal kick.
They have 5 minutes left, and the coaches are telling them that right now as they are wanting to pick it up.
5 minutes left of all these coaches are chanting, making sure they get that to the player's head, making them play even harder.
Mm-hmm. Because the coaches really want to win this. They don't want to be standing out here for no reason.
Yes, they do. And Brentwood Academy once more with the ball.
They've been in control for a while here.
Yes, they have.
Probably over at least 10 minutes, I think.
Yeah, a good 10 minutes of this half has been on Brentwood's, Brentwood's property right now. Looks like Brentwood Academy 23 trying to keep the ball outside.
And good play by Christian Suffrage.
Their half. Christian Suffrage pressuring them up.
Ooh.
Ooh. Nice save by Sean Anderson. Sean Anderson looks like he's a little hurt from that, but he's still doing good.
Oh, dang.
Ooh, 26.
Oh, yes.
Cameron Dow with a nice slider right there.
That's very good for Fairview.
Yes, it is.
Oh, he ran that ball down.
Might be a pass. Pass back to number three. Pass to number
eight. Brentwood Academy. A nice header right there. And there's just a lot of Brentwood Academy players compared to Fairview right there.
And number 17, Justin, getting the ball out of that side of Fairview side of the field. Number 10, passing it back down to the goalie. Ref calls.
Offsides.
Offsides, it looks like.
And it's good to see Fairview get it out of there.
Yes, it is definitely a good thing to see when Fairview gets the ball out of their side of the field, pushing it right on down to Brentwood. Fairview it's Brentwood's ball right here. Number 10 with a strong kick downfield to number, misses that.
Oh, gosh. The captain.
Number 7, McKay right there. But the ball goes out of bounds again from
they kick it out of bounds.
Jesse Wright.
They don't play. They kick it as far as they can.
Want to make sure they can run out the clock, but the one thing that they shouldn't do about that is they need to have more time to score that goal.
Yeah, I think Fairview's just won this path to be over without a goal because Brentwood Academy has had way too many chances not to score
here. Yes, they have. I think Fairview's going to try to make this go into overtime.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to get a PK.
Yes, good job.
The shootout.
Oh,
there's
nice kick downfield.
Ooh, Sean Anderson trying to get on that ball, but he got ahead of it. The ball stopped as soon as he got caught up. Sean Anderson, a little slip right there, but he catches up.
And
he still in his possession.
Great ball handling skills right
yes,
here.
He does.
Oh, he just misses the pass.
But there's a little interruption right there from Brentwood. Header by Jason Arnold. Number 5, Brentwood Academy, keeping on the ball. A little strong kick, pushed him over. Ooh, a fall right there.
Oh, I think that was a little unnecessary. I think he fell down more than he was pushed right there. And that both teams are...
Nice strong kick from Brentwood. A nice save from Benji Gonzalez. Benji Gonzalez is a freshman who's played this entire game as the goalkeeper for Fairview. Dominic Hazelwood taking off his hat to make sure he gets that ball.
Yeah, he has taken off his hat every time he gets kicked.
That's like his move, man. He has to take off his hat just to be hyped up.
I think it might throw off the defender.
Yeah, it might. Fairview High School trying to keep the ball out of the side.
Ooh. Oh, and Brentwood Academy scores.
Brentwood Academy within 2 minutes left on the clock.
Oh, my goodness. Brentwood Academy is so happy, but there still is time left for Fairview. Right here.
Fairview couldn't possibly come back up for this game. They don't have much time, so they better, if they're going to try to do this, they're going to have to do it as fast as they can. We're starting to pick up a little bit again. Fairview High School playing relentlessly now. They need this goal.
Mm-hmm. And they need it fast.
Yes, they do. Christian Shelby trying to get that ball down, but... Ooh, nice strong header by Jesse Wright. Looks a little dazed right there, dazed and confused, but he's still playing. Dominic Hazel with the ball, passing it on down to number 5, Jake Sanders. Jake Sanders trying to keep it out of... Ooh, nice play by Jake Sanders. Mm-hmm. Passing down to Christian Shelby. Christian Shelby on down to number 3, back to number 5. Ooh, but the defender sat on the ball right there, making sure it doesn't get anywhere. But... got a little bit ahead.
They can't have them clear it out here. They need to keep it on their side so they can't blow the whistle.
Yes, they do. This is definitely
intense. And he kicks it up.
Nice.
Oh, and he saves it. Yeah. I hope they don't kick it down. Oh.
Good save.
And it looks like it's about to be the game. No, that was a great play by Shelby.
Recovering the ball, passing it on down to Dominic Hazelwood.
And out of bounds.
Throw in, Dominic Hazelwood down to Christian Shelby, passing it back to Jesse Wright on down to the goal, but goalie is confused.
Oh, it's out of bounds.
Out of bounds. Both teams, Sean Anderson calling for corner kick, goalie calling for goal kick.
They don't have much time.
High School. No, sorry, corner kick for Fairview High School. Dominic Hazelwood setting up.
Oh, this game is crazy right now.
Yes, these players are insanely hyped up for this kick.
Oh, and it's nice stop, but it's still going in there.
It's hard for Fairview to get this goal because of all the defense and pressure right here.
Everybody's trying to kick it out, and Fairview's trying to kick it in.
Go, Nick! To the corner!
Oh, gosh, and that could be the game.
That was a nice play from Brentwood Academy, making sure that they can run out the time for Fairview.
Brentwood Academy wants them to blow the whistle right now, but
yes,
Fairview's trying to keep it as fast.
Catch back up. And that is it for the
game. Well, it's been a great game between Brentwood Academy and Fairview Yellow Jackets. But Brentwood Academy comes...
They came in hard, making sure the ball stays on Fairview side, and that's how they ended the game.
Yeah, that's how they won, 2-1. But it was a great game.
Good sportsmanship going on between the teams, shaking hands before the lines are even made.
Yep, it was a nice, well-played game, and it was a must-see.
It was a good game, and like you said, a good watch.
Yes, I would like to watch this game on TV when I get home.
I would like that, too, in the comfort of my nice house with the hot chocolate in my hand.
Yes. A nice hot chocolate and a blanket over me. Okay, and this is Isaac Evanson
and Josh Bramwell
signing off.
Fairview High School, Brentwood Academy Soccer.